as we've been looking at some of the prayers of Scripture over the last few weeks, I want to look at one that's not exactly a prayer, but it was a statement made to Jesus, and so I think that counts. In John 6, Jesus had been doing a lot of teaching to the people who were following him. And in verse 60 of that chapter, his disciples are having a conversation. And it says, "Therefore, many of his disciples, when they heard this, said, 'This is a difficult statement. Who can listen to it?'" And then as it went on, it tells us that many people left. In verse 66, it says, "As a result of this, many of his disciples withdrew and were not walking with him anymore." They were finding Jesus' teachings too hard, too confusing, too difficult to follow. And so they went away. And then Jesus asked his disciples that were with him, the 12, this question. So Jesus said to the 12, "You do not want to go away also, do you?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God." And I would say we could use that as a prayer of steadfastness. There are times in our faith when it is difficult to understand what God is doing, when it is difficult to make the choice to live obediently to Scripture. But the bottom line, as Peter said, was, where else are we going to go? God in Christ is the one who has eternal life. And as we have believed and as we have come to know, we understand better who he is and what he does. And when we have that understanding, then we can make that prayer of steadfastness where we say, even when it's hard, even when others turn away, I want to keep in my mind, there's nowhere else to go because you are the way, the truth, and the life. Say in the Psalms, the psalmist came to somewhat the same conclusion when he wrote in Psalm 73 and verse 25, "Whom have I in heaven but you? And beside you, I desire nothing on earth. My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever." When we're going through difficult times, when what the Bible is asking of us seems hard, when it is difficult to live counterculturally, when we are having doubts, let's remind ourselves of that prayer of steadfastness. Lord, where else can we go? You are the one who gives eternal life. You are the one who is our rock. You are the one who is our portion forever. Help my desire to be only you. Amen.